French presidency of the Council of the European Union will start next January. The upcoming French presidency will most likely be perturbed by the French presidential elections scheduled for April 2022, during which Emmanuel Macron will try to show his ability to protect French interests in the EU context. However, if Emmanuel Macron wants to fulfill his promises and make this presidency a stepping stone in the European Union integration process, he will have to ensure to Europeanize the French presidency, meaning to ensure that the proposals and the solutions put forward by France respond to a wider European and not merely French interest and view. The reinforcement of the Franco-German alliance will also be on the table, since Germany is about to send its new leader Olaf Scholz to the European Council. However, this time the usual suspects will have to ensure to enlarge and make this alliance as inclusive as possible. There are in particular three areas in which this is particularly important. One is to show what strategic autonomy practically entails. Second, to execute the recovery fund and also put forward the reforms of the governance. And third, trying to give substance to the conference on the future of Europe.
The strategic compass is meant to make the EU a capable or even only a more relevant actor in security and defence. There's already enough debate about whether 5,000 troops strong rapid deployment capacity is sufficient and or feasible. This is why our recommendations instead focus on the blind spots in the compass strap. We have three recommendations. First point, civilian crisis management. It's more than a simple benefit of having it in a toolbox. To name one example, the climate security nexus is relevant for the military, sure, and it's good that it also takes responsibility there, but civilian measures are the adequate approach here and should be featured more prominently. Second point, missions life cycles. CSDP missions should never become a fig leaf for the EU or the host country. That's why it must be clear and transparent what should be achieved and why, when the mission is accomplished, and also when it might leave without having the mission accomplished. Last point, resilience. It's a fuzzy term, many things fall under it, many other initiatives in Compass and beyond have resilience aspects to them. We propose a monitoring that collects all initiatives already in place, be it on the local, regional, national or EU level. This way, we can learn from things that work, get aware of holes in the umbrella and can spend resources more efficiently.
France is a European and a Mediterranean power. Therefore, it is well placed to promote the Mediterranean as part of the EU agenda and also to enhance the role of the EU in the southern neighborhood and beyond. In our document, we've outlined four areas where France could make a difference, where France could contribute. The first, to preserve the inclusive nature of Euro-Mediterranean relations over the zero-sum game that has been prevalent in many parts of the region. The second is also to implement the ideas that we have in the new agenda for the Mediterranean in cooperation with the EU institutions, as well as with the upcoming rotating presidencies of the EU. The third, to anchor the Mediterranean as part of the discussion on the strategic autonomy of the European Union. And last but not least, we need to still cope with the social consequences of the pandemic. We need better social services, better health services, not only in Europe, but also in the Mediterranean. We need in Europe to protect, but also in Mediterranean to protect, a Mediterranean that protects.
The climate agenda has long been a priority for both the European Union and France. And it is even more urgent considering the current climate crisis which we see unfolding. The Fit for 55 package is the cornerstone of EU climate policy today. The French presidency should promote a swift implementation of the package, starting from the revision of the most relevant legislation. It should also focus on strengthening emission standards for new cars, in line with the objectives that the Commission has recently presented. Regarding the Green Deal, French Presidency should also make sure that the carbon border adjustment mechanism is implemented in a way that does not lead to conflict with trade partners.